Hello. Well, after all that, I think we might be back on. It's only taken till half time. Foxes went ahead 1-0 early doors. Yellow for Dan Hope, which I haven't allocated yet, so I should. Hope he gets the ball. Plays the ball through. Peacock trying to take on his man. Has he got the pace to? Not quite, but he does have the skills, and referee's going to call a foul the other way. Have to say it's been quite a heated game. Both teams obviously keen for a win and playing accordingly. Not sure what that's for, Lance. Good question. That's a long kick, and Marinelli's going to take that on the chest. We're nearing half time. As I said, 1-0 the Foxes. Going into a howling breeze, as you can see by that kick. Marinelli's done well to get that anywhere near halfway. Galbraith, good control in a difficult conditions, and Fabian comes through. Maynard trying to control it, can't. That's Peterson loses possession. That's going to be a foul, and Favier with a yellow card. Yellow card's mounting up for the Foxes here. That's in a dangerous position with this wind, that's for sure. Referee's going to have a chat to Hampson, because he's obviously having a bit of a few words. He might even find himself in the book. No, he's happy with that. And we'll take it back for the free kick right in front of the goals, just outside the D. What? I'm not sure what that signal was, Lance. Okay. It's been an interesting shot, though. Well and truly within range, particularly with this howling wind behind him. Shoots on the ground, interestingly enough. Another one, calls for handballs, as is customary. And the ball goes back into the Oxley defensive line. He takes a long kick, bit wasted there as we're approaching half time. Just going into extras now, and no, we're not. It's referee will call it straight away. The end of the first half, it's Foxes 1, Oxley 0. We'll see if we can come back with a bit better performance from ourselves in the second half.
I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? And touching hands, reaching out, touching me. Wasn't the spring
and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me. Summer, who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me.
Let's see if we can have a bit more luck with the stream this half. Early goal to Josh Peacock in the 6 minute. Took it out to 1-0 as the referee blows his whistle for the second half. Oxley running left to right on your screen into a very strong breeze. It's going to be a challenge for them, but they did well in the first half. The Foxes against that. So let's see if Oxley can do similar as Brown loses possession. Well defended. Oxley come back through the middle. Hopes there to hopefully clean up. That wasn't a pun, but it came out that way. Ball drops back in. That's a lovely ball out to the right hand side. Difficult to control in these conditions, but does well. Hampson gets feigned out, and there's Logan at the back. He gets a touch. It's the first time we've seen him today, carrying a cork injury to the thigh. Hampson, a lovely bit of footwork. Can he find Aynard? He can, but not too happy with the contact, but the referee says otherwise. Losing him to Garside, out to Brown. Brown tries to find Hope coming through the middle. He does, but takes a little bobble and then plays the ball into the Oxley feet. Beats the man coming back, and we'll play it back to Garside, who wasn't quite ready for it, and he tries it. Maynard misses him all together, and Oxley away. Lovely ball through the middle. It's found no one, and Garside has to be a little bit quicker there as Marinelli yells out to him exactly that. Goes out for an Oxley throw. Lovely long throw into the breeze as it just dies down for a second. Oxley drag into the 18-yard box and kick it back out. A lovely ball forward, but Marinelli's going to watch that go well and truly over the bar. Be interesting to see how far Marinelli kicks this with this breeze, because he's kicking just up to halfway into it, out of his hands. And as expected, similar off the deck in this half. I believe that a Thorogood with the long throw. I haven't seen any of it in the first half. And as you can see, Brown's trying to get it, and he might have just pinched it. No, well covered by Oxley. The wind's going to carry that over for a corner. Maynard with the corner on the left-hand side of the pitch. It'll be tough to keep this in. Gonna have to start it out near the penalty spot to get any purchase on it, which he doesn't. And that wasn't bad in the end. Hampson almost getting his head on it, and Oxley forced it out for another throw for the Foxes. Logan with the throw, not sure why. No, he hands it over for Thorogood. And straight away the men get into the box. And that's why on that win. Lovely throw towards Peacock, gets a head into it, but I didn't think anyone was out the back, but Maynard does well to come back and recover it. And then gets brought down. No, the other way around. Oxley free kick just on the 18-yard box, as you can see there. Peacock comes in to make sure there's no shorter on. And they play it anyway. But there's the error. I think Peacock forced that one. Unfortunately, Maynard couldn't get control of it. Ball comfortably through the middle. Turns. Tries to find his man on the right wing back and does. Thorogood knocks it out for a throw. A lovely long throw into the breeze, and Peterson misjudges it. Ball through, catches Logan out of place, ball into the middle. Wisden does well to get a heel to it, and Hope cleans up, but doesn't find Thorogood with his pass. Logan not fouled. Play on, ball banged into the middle, but that's going to float over the top. There's a couple of Oxley players out the back. They'll take a shot, and it's an absolute ripper of a shot, but just wide. Wind couldn't get any stronger as it kicks up again. Certainly making our job interesting. Trying to bring this game to you. Let's see if Marinelli kicks it as a result with his goal kick. Look at that one. It's going to go... No, everyone misjudged it. As it goes over two Clairvaux heads. Peterson gets ahead to it, but it comes back with pace. Again, he knocks it out to Hope, who puts a lovely through ball. Can Brown get onto that? I think he might be able to. Not quite. They play it back to the keeper, and good pressure by Peacock, and keeper does well to go around his man. Brown holding it up. Gets beaten just down the right, the left-hand side of their attack, and comes back through the middle and drops it into the middle of the park, and that's some nice football. Albeit Peterson working ultra hard just to make sure I speak the wrong thing, and Brown takes a touch forward, but that's going to be too big for him. The keeper does well. Wynn just caught it again, making things tough for the Foxes up top. There's a good ball into their 10. He's got men running through, but oh, Garside gets tripped over and they'll get the foul. Marinelli trying to find Brown with a lovely long ball in front of him. He's got the touch on it. Can he bring it down? Not quite. And Oxley tried to control and hit it out for a throw-in. Lovely ball from Marinelli there on that breeze. Rose in the middle. Hampson holds it up. Brown back to Garside, who doesn't approach it quickly enough, and Oxley away on the fast break. Number of players running through the middle to help him out, and the Fox is not getting back quickly enough, to be honest. Maynard holds him up, needed to, and Hampson gets a foot in, but it's gone straight to the opposition. Thorogood's got to work hard. Oh, very well done by Hope, and Marinelli comes and fixes it. He's come from an offside position though. That's a foul. A yellow card awarded. One of the Oxley players received the card, but not before Peacock was adjudged offside. Just inside their own half. Be difficult to find a man long with this, so he plays a short one as expected, and then Peacock decides he's going to press high as they pump it out to the left-hand side, and Garside gets pushed off the ball, but the referee's okay with that. And he loses control and regains it back nicely, but Woosnam comes flying through and puts it all the way down the other end, and Peacock comes out try and stop his man, but the keeper comes out and picks it up and rolls it out. Slow from Oxley here. Maynard does well to get half a foot in just to send him on the back, and then the long ball tried. I think that was errant, but it's come out better than expected. Oxley down the right hand side now. It's a lovely ball, holding it up on the breeze. Garside, it's going to be a struggle for him. He can't control it. They pull it up and play it back in for a shot, but that's Woosnam again. He does really well, and then Garside comes back and saves the day down the right-hand side, but bangs it out for an Oxley throw-in. Long throw into the breeze, hits Hampson in the thigh. Ends up coming, oh, back Brown's way, and accidentally kicks him in the head. No malice there, just an error. Oh, he's giving him a yellow for it. I don't know about that. Still 1-0 the Foxes, 55th minute approaching. Bang. Again over the top. Had it from Oxley, not going in the direction he wanted it, and Brown comes back to get it again. Can he keep it in? Or he might have. Peacock, brilliant! Unbelievable finish from Josh Peacock. You won't see many better than that, and I hope Lance got all of it, because that takes the Foxes out to a 2-0 lead. Brown with the effort to keep the ball in, and then Peacock with an amazing finish. Be pretty happy with that one, I think, the Foxes. That makes it Foxes 2, Oxley 0, Peacock 2. We're off again. 56 minutes gone. Oxley probably got to get the next goal. Although Thorogood just bombs one downfield on that wind, and that's not going to do anything. Possibly let it roll out for a goal kick. Keeper looking for something short, and Peacock making life tough there. Comes out the left-hand side. Ball over the top. Logan does well, probably a foul in that, but gets away with it. Ball's played forward from Gar's side to Brown. Again, Brown making a nuisance of himself. Have we got a second wave? No. And he takes him to on and loses it, but it goes out for a Fox's throw. Early throw to Peterson. Peterson's struggling to control that, but Gar's side can, and he plays it into Brown, but Brown runs over the top of it. Hope stands his man up. That's a lovely bit of play to go forward. They're playing quite well through the midfield, Oxley. Just get a bit lost when they get a bit higher. This bloke's been good. There's another strong ball. Touched on. And there's the error. Logan kicks it into his defender. Probably should have done better there. And Hampson jumps over the slide tackle for a Fox's throw. Thorogood, massive throw this time. If that beats him, it could be on here, and it does. It's flicked in front, and he gets fouled. No idea how that wasn't a foul, but anyway, play on. Good work by Hampson. Throw from Oxley. Thorogood does well, but that's gone a mile in the sky. Can he keep him in? Not quite. Yes, he can. Peacock working overtime and does brilliantly well to keep it in. Oh, very well done by Peacock. Ends up with the throw, and this is where Thorogood can be dangerous. Can he put it in on someone's head into the middle? There's not as many people in the middle as should be, but Hope's out the back for it. Peacock looking to try and get his third. Can't get ahead on it. Hampson can play it back into Thorogood. Thorogood, a lovely backstick ball. Hope still lurking. Oh, he's headed that. Oh, I'm not sure about what he was doing there. They come away with it though, Oxley, and in the end Thorogood runs under it. And referee was ready to give a foul there, but plays good advantage. That's a nice ball, well controlled, and Logan's going to come through. And the referee decided that was a foul a long time after it was a foul. Ranelli with the long ball after all of that. Not sure what happened whatsoever. Referee calling him on and not calling him on. And in the end, Ranelli kicks it all the way down the other end. And keeper plays it out in the direction of Woosnam. Woosnam takes a touch, plays the ball forward, but goes straight to Oxley there. Good pick up by Maynard running through. Can he find Brown? He can. Brown, some lovely feet. Plays it back to Maynard, in towards Peacock. Couldn't quite control it as well as he hoped. Brown putting some pressure on him, but the defender for Oxley does really well. Into the middle. Hope plays the ball, and again in the direction of Brown. That's where most of it's come from. Maynard puts it out in front of Brown. Even he's not going to be able to get that one. Goal kick, plays it early. Cross goal, down the right hand side now. They play a long ball, trying to go over Thorogood, which he does. Can he keep it in? Really well done. Takes his time and plays the ball in the middle, but that only as far as Hampson, and then Thorogood hits the man, and that was Peterson, actually. That was Hampson before, and then Peterson plays that one. Peacock, oh, a very good tackle. Long throw from Thorogood. They're still not onto that, the Oxley team. And Brown makes a nuisance of himself. Ball pops back into the middle fortuitously. And that goes over his head. And that's a very good controlled pass. Plays it forward again, but Logan reads it nicely. And he plays the ball into Peterson. Is it strong enough? Not quite. This guy hasn't played too badly. He's got some nice touches on him. And there's another one. Holds it up. That's not going to work. Maynard gets the ball. Cops a kick on the ground, and that'll be a free kick to the Foxes. Oh. 62 minutes gone. Foxes 2, Oxley 0. That ball's going to miss everyone. Good touch by Bishop. Has a chance to fire if he wants. Can't. Oh, plays a lovely ball out of Hope. Can he finish? No. A lovely save. Maynard tries to get a foot in, but that doesn't go in the right direction, so Peterson gets another go. Ball comes out the other side. He hits it straight to Thorogood, who could put one in here, and that's a lovely shot. Still 2-0 to the Foxes. 64th minute coming up as Hope makes his way to the bench and Haynes are on. Hot pressing high. Didn't quite work, pressing as one, but plays into the middle there. A nice long ball. It's going to sit on that wind well, and Marinelli gets an awkward bounce and does exceptionally well, and Thorogood keeps it in as well. Haynes, it beats everybody. Straight up in the air. Ball comes down finally to Peterson. A lovely touch. He's got Hampson there. If Haynes can play him, he can't. He'll go out for a Clairvaux throw. Thorogood again. There's Brown making the move. Can it beat the defender? Not quite, but it's not really they're not really working it out, Oxley. That long throw is pretty simple to pick off. And there's Hampson, a little ball through. Again, not quite to Brown. That's better football. They're away now. Through the middle. And then Haynes picks that up. Drops it back to Fabia. Fabia turns on his man. Thorogood using Marinelli. Couple of dodgy bounces, but he does really well as expected. Bishop, can he get a touch with his head? Very well done. Ball goes out for a clever throw. Early throw from Haynes in the direction of Peterson. Peterson Nice little run. Can he get another foot in? Not quite. Oh, he might have. Got it out to Brown, who fires off the upright. Peterson, an air swing. We're still in the middle of it, and in the end, the referee finds a foul. Plays the ball out short. Hits one over the top, but Garside read it the best of the three. Plays in the direction of Brown, but wrong foots him, and Garside picks it up again. Here it's Maynard. Maynard onto Bishop. Bishop. A nice ball out in front of Brown. A little bit too big, though. The keeper runs out and picks it up. Oxley coming down the left-hand side again. Plays it out in front of his man. Marinelli was tracking back, but decides, nope, I'm going to come out and pick that one up. And he does comfortably. Wind dies down for half a second. Marinelli puts it in the direction of Brown. Very well done by Brown, but can't control it completely. The defender does well to run around him, but again, Brown holds him up, and that allows Maynard to get a good touch in the middle, and Hampson did okay, but not enough on it, and Oxley come away. Ball through the middle. He's got a man out on the right. He takes him. He's got a man out wider if he wants to use him as well. Stands him up, plays it back, comes back. I'm not sure what he's doing here. He's just... In the end, he finds his man down the left-hand side. Ball into the middle. Hampson cleans up nicely, and Garside is making no mistakes there, and that allows Brown to get a foot onto it, but not enough. That's Hampson coming back. Oh, and Logan reads it beautifully. I'm not sure what the man's fallen over for there, but he's standing in an offside position. I'm not sure there was a foul there at all. I think Logan went clean on that one. Hampson fighting hard, does really well. The defender tries to bring him down. And that's onside. That's completely onside. Anyway, he's called it offside. I'm not sure why, but we'll go on. Ball into the middle. Nice ball over the top, but Thurgood gets a good foot on it. And Haynes will try and shut down his man. He tries to play the ball early and gets lucky with the touch, and that's a good one. Out to the right-hand side, pops it out front of his man. This is where Logan no doubt will try and foul someone. Oh, and he does really well there, Dan Favier. And Garside does even better. Can Hampson get a touch? He can't. Garside can, but it's gone out for a throw. Maynard misses it. Oxley hold it up, play it back into the defensive line. Looking for a runner, none forthcoming, so holds it up. There's half a ball that hits Peterson in the chops. Lovely little flick on, beats Garside, takes it to the byline. Can he cut it back in? Looking for another wave, but Garside does very well, but only as far as the next line of defenders, and they play it into the middle. Opportunity to get into the 18-yard box, which he takes, and a lovely tackle by Peterson there. He plays Hampson. He's got Brown outside him. He should really... That's a lovely ball. Brown's on goal. Brown's on goal here. Can he slot it? The keeper comes out. The keeper doesn't get it. Into the middle. And over the top. That wind just causing a few dramas for him. Otherwise, that could have been three. Early play out from the keeper. Good pressing by the Foxes. Can Bishop steal one? He can. He... Lays it back to Maynard. I should put his laces through it. And he doesn't quite. That's a better one. Now he could. Maynard gets around his man. It is a bit of comedy capers here. There's not much good football going on. Brown, beaten. Oxley away at the end. Bishop, can't get the ball. Gets it taken. Garside's run around. Hampson, he won't leave anything in the bank, and he doesn't. And he plays the ball out in front of Hampson, but again, it's too long. Frustrating to watch. And both fall over. Probably as bad as each other there, so no problems. If Oxley can just pinch one here, it'll be... Oh, lovely ball, but he's put it way over the top. Another goal kick for Marinelli. 2-0 the Foxes, 71 minutes gone. Oh, long ball forward, well headed by the defender. Maynard from a back position. Bishop kicks it up. Maynard again. Gets the ball taken off him beautifully. Oxley away here. Ball out in front. Calls him offside, but far from it. Logan does very well. But he turns back into the middle of all ways and then hits it straight to the next oncoming Oxley player. Peterson, brilliant. Not far off the best player on the field today, Will Peterson. He's had a strong game. Oh, that's another error. Haynes takes his man on. Could play him. Instead, he just loses it completely. Sorry, should be a bit more impartial there, but that's a lovely touch. Can he fire? He can't. And the flag stays down for the pen. I possibly would have given that one, I think. Throw it back to the keeper. Marinelli puts his foot through that. That's a lovely kick. Galbraith, a lovely ball to Hampson, who plays it back to Galbraith, who plays it back into Hampson. It comes off the back of his calf. Thought Brown could have pinched that. Brown slides back into his customary 10 position, letting Galbraith play out the right wing. Ball, lovely ball over the top. Can get Thorogood get there? Luckily he could. And Favia. And I don't think the Foxes should foul him here because I don't think he'll not give a second pen. Galbraith should switch this to Haynes. Brown again. Dinosaur, he doesn't. He plays it on to Galbraith, who's onside, but he overruns it. Can he keep it in? He can. And that's called offside eventually. No, that brings it up. Now he's going to take it back. Well, that's the linesman's error there, because the linesman told him to bring it back, up, and then the referee sent him back. There we go. We're away anyway. All right. It's all good. Logan does well. Garside better. but loses it eventually. It's a nice ball through. Marinelli's going to have to come out and pick that one up. He doesn't. He plays it and makes a few dramas, but they were very strong from Peterson. Very strong. He plays Brown. Brown opens up onto his left foot and then plays a ball in front of Haynes. I've pre-eminated that. He should have been running. I think I made that word up too. Yep, made that word up for you, Lance. Preempted is the word I was looking for. Cooper takes a second to gain his composure and puts the ball out to the left-hand side. Garside again getting a foot in, doing very well today also. Keeper's ball once more. At 2-0 down, it's odd that he's taking his time, but anyway, maybe that's why, because that's a terrible kick. Garbraith, can he get his foot on it? No, that player's beaten him comfortably there. And again, and then a lovely ball out to the right-hand side. Thorogood holds his man up and then has Favier back if he wants, or he can go forward down the line to Haynes and decides the ladder and kicks it out. Ball through the middle. They've got men down this left-hand side, Oxley, and that's a lovely ball over top, but well done by Dan Logan. And brilliant bit of control. And Thorogood does well after the poor kick. Keeps it in. Hampson turns back. He's got an opportunity to switch it, but brilliant little steal there. But he loses it in turn. And then Logan gets absolutely wiped out, and that'll be a yellow card. It's a third yellow card for Oxley. Marinelli going long again, looking at Haynes. Can it beat the defender? Not quite, but the second touch comes through the middle and out to Peterson again. He does strongly, but the defender does better and then beats his man, which was brilliant. Hampson comes away with it, plays it to Brown. Brown plays it out in front of Galbraith. Galbraith has a chance to shoot. Well done by the keeper. Galbraith, another go maybe? No, it's Hampson. He holds it up. He's got the opportunity to hit Galbraith again, and he misses. Early ball out, but then the defender holds it up. Tries to hit a long ball, but Favier's there comfortably, and he puts the ball back to where it came from. Does beautifully well and then leans back into Haynes. Haynes fighting hard, doesn't quite get there, and it's a good ball down the side, but Thorogood comes through and beats his man. Sorry, suspicion. Anyway, Oxley free kick after all that. And then he kicks it into Haynes. Doesn't matter, and we're away, and Brown could get a touch on. Hold that up for a throw-in. What do we got? 10.5 minutes left. Thorogood with the throw. Where's the runner? No runner this time, so we hit Brown. Brown controls it. Get sandwiched and we'll get a foul. Now he's going to get a yellow for throwing the ball away, I reckon. Maybe not. Maybe he just gets a talking to. He could at least stand up while the referee's talking to him, I think. He gets away with it. <laughs> 10 minutes remaining. 2-0 the Foxes. bit of tall timber in the box for the Foxes, which is good to see. Maynard, a low ball. Oh, it misses everything. They play it back out. Thorogood plays Haynes. Haynes controls it nicely. He's got Maynard lapping him. Instead, he takes him on and he gets pushed over, and he's going to give him a pen for that. I don't know why, but he's going to give him a pen. Hampson stepping up for the penalty for the Foxes. Can he put this one away and therefore put the game away? The goalkeeper also has the sun to contend with. He does a good job, but not quite enough. And the third goal goes in for the Foxes. Goal to Riley Hampson. Go again. 8 minutes remaining, and Galbraith steals it, and he's away. He's got Hampson there. Will he take a shot himself? He doesn't. He plays in the middle, but not a very good cross, if that's what it was. Haynes pressing high, controls the keeper, and then the keeper, stinker of a kick. Garside can't quite get the bounce just to fix it for him, and he'll get another go. Galbraith's going to press him after seeing what he's done so far. Takes a touch around him. Good ball forward. Drops it back off. That's better football by Oxley. Really nice there. Can they find a man out here on the right-hand side? They can't. Fabia. Then Maynard. But Maynard hits the ball in the wrong direction. And then he gets one in a lucky ricochet. Hampson's away. Can he play Galbraith or Brown? He can't. He holds it up. And he finds Logan. Logan. Oh, bouncing ball out of Fabia. That's tough. And he does really well. Finds Haynes. Doesn't beat his man. That came off his hand. There's no doubt about that. And that came off Maynard's hand. So we've had two off the hands. Still play on. And Thorogood does well. Oh, very well, in fact. He could play it out to Galbraith or in front of Thorogood. A lovely ball. Can Thorogood get a touch? The wind is against him. The keeper takes a touch. The keeper's away. Oh, and it hits the referee. And fortunately, that'll be a drop ball. Oxley play the ball on. Another good run out to the left-hand side. Certainly been strong through the midfield. Just nothing really up top has worked for him. And, well, that's gone over the top. But Thorogood gets in the way and he plays in the direction of Haynes. He couldn't see it during the sun or bit on the ground. He could play Galbraith. No, he holds it up instead and plays the ball to Brown. Brown held onto it for too long. In the direction of Logan. He's not going to take a backward step there. You can expect that. Really good tackle from Oxley though, and away they come. What are they going to do? Nothing really. Fabia, too good. Plays it out to Haynes, cops a kick for his troubles. 5 minutes to go, that's a nice little header back. Haynes could have done better with that ball through. Coach Bishop blowing up the Lux here. A lovely turn by Maynard, and he plays it to Galbraith, but it just pops behind him and has to stop and prop, and then the ball out in front of Hampson, but that's going to be way too long. Offside anyway. Keeper rolls it out. Right hand side this time. Oh, that was interesting. Logan wasn't going to take a backward step. Neither was the Oxley player, and that comes away with a foul. Well, we've got 4.5 minutes to go. Plenty of fouls in this match. Logan plays it quickly to Fabia. Fabia plays Brown. Ball bobbles. He gets beaten in the end. He's lost it a few times like that, Kieran Brown, today, and that's not like him. And Logan does very well to get in the way of that one. And then the ball goes forward, and he'd have to be about 2 metres offside.
And his shot, and he'll make it to the six.
Oh,
stick the fork in, mate.
Referee and the lino are going to have a chat about something that's completely inconsequential here, rather than let the game go. Yeah. Okay, he's going to have a chat to him for kicking the ball away. Long ball again, beats everyone. Oh, that's not the best play I've ever seen either by the defender. And the keeper's going for another little gallop. I'd hate him to lose it here. I'd hate him to lose it here. In the end, we've got a shot on if he wants it, Haynes. Well, that's a stinker. Three nil with 3 minutes to go. Out for an Oxley throw. A couple of minutes to go in this one. Foxes cleaning this game up comfortably. Keep them in second place on the ladder in the reserve grade. That ball ends up at the right wing back, but look at the wind get on that one. Pushes forward. Haynes stands him up as best he can. Ends up coming away with it, and that's going to be a card of the ridiculous proportions, and that's going to be his red. He was obviously keen to go home, so he's going to have a sit down. Just hopefully we can get through this game with no more rubbish. Only a minute of time before extras, so nice ball through from Thorogood over the top. Galbraith not going to get there. Keeper picks it up comfortably. He rolls it out, and that isn't the option, I can promise you that. And he's, I don't know what's going on here, I really don't. This is, that's a foul. Ball forward, Garside and Logan. Former takes it, Galbraith misses it. Ball comes back to him. Galbraith plays in the middle to Hampson. Hampson gets tackled nicely. And the ball goes forward again. They're doing well down that left hand side. That ball's put forward and he's been called for offside. Logan drops it out to Favier. Favier's got Haynes if he can find him. He might, yeah, he thinks against it and plays it out to Thorogood as we into extra time now. 26 seconds gone. Oh, Marinelli said, okay, if the keeper down that end can do it, we'll do it. But makes a meal of it. And goes out for an Oxley throw. Hampson does very well. Does very well again. Plays the ball forward, and there's Bishop. Has he got a pace to beat him? He might. He might. He's got the time. And I've got no words for that. I didn't see it, but anyway, all good. Nice ball by Maynard, and very well cleared as well, and that'll be the end of that game. In the end, it was Foxes 3, Oxley 0. Goal scorers 2 to Peacock and 1 to Riley Hampson from the penalty spot. We'll be back in 12 minutes for the main game.
where it began. I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hand, touching hands, reaching out, touching me. Summer, who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me. Thank you.
where it began. I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me.
Just about ready for the main game now. Just about ready for the main game now. Running through the team list there. We got Weaver. Let's have a look at it over here. This will give us a better look at it. Weaver, Potter, Sewell. Sewell's been in great form of late. When is he not, I guess is the question. Nevis, Snape, Knowles, Hickling, Comer, Chapman, Makumi, Pisani. Sisto's a late scratching, pulled up with an injury, and McLean's on the bench. And from the resis, I can see down there we've got Peacock, we've got Hope, we've got Haynes, and Dylan Woosnam on the bench after having some very good performances in reserve grade of late. Referees are out in the middle. I'll just flick the Rezzy's game off. Both teams right up the pointy end of the table at the moment. And both on a bit of a run of wins, or at least undefeated run. Foxes, you have to go back to April 30 for their one and only loss for the season against North Brisbane. They made amends of it last week against them here at the Den. And Oxley, as I said, have been playing very well of late. Had their fair share of wins recently, so it should be a good match tonight, one I've been looking forward to this week, albeit freezing cold. Looks like the Foxes will swap and go from left to right into the wind to start. Knowles has donned the blue skins under garment on the torso this evening. Who could blame him? Looks like Mapri's got the two big fellas up top in Snape and Pisani. See how they work together after having a really good effort last week. Referee checking his watch. All in readiness, lights on. Away we go. Knowles with the ball first. He puts a long ball in the direction of McCormie bombing on, but comfortably covered by the defender there. And Chapman comes through to clean it up. This ball stays in. Hickling a ball over top. Pisani can't quite get there, but Knowles coming through can. He plays it in the direction of Pisani again. He loses the foot. Sewell. Sewell to Coma, dodgy bounce there for him, so he's forced to work hard. Gets it back to Chapman. Chapman out to Hickling. Hickling decides to go forward instead to McCormie. McCormie, man of the match last week with a scintillating display of speed and his normal tenacity. Chapman does well to get a touch there, but so does the Oxley player, and then they play it out wider. Oh, a lovely side foot touch. Chapman allows him to run past him and get it. Understanding the wind has just settled for a minute and they're into the box and Nevis can't control it, and that's not a shot, it's going to go straight across the face and out for a throw in. McCormie with the ball for the throw. He's going to try and find Pisani, which he does. He gets a nice little bit of control on it and finds Knowles. Knowles looking for a runner. He can't, so he finds Hickling instead down the left-hand side. Hickling has Snape high. Can he find him? No, but certainly a dangerous ball nonetheless. He gets the ball back and plays the ball to Coma, who has it pinched off him. He and Sewell fight over the ball, which is good to see. They drop it back to Hickling again. Potter's still very high on the right-hand side if they can find him. He stood there for a good couple of minutes just waiting for a ball. Plays it back to Chapman. Chapman out to Nevis. Nevis can see Potter now. They've finally made their way over to him, but they've left him plenty of space. Nevis plays a lovely ball into Pisani. The keeper plucks it out of the air easily. Ball tucked in through the middle. McCormie controls that one in the direction of Knowles. Knowles, a lovely ball in front of Snape, but he's been called for offside. And the referee will pull that one up. Strong start to the Foxes. Free kick down the right-hand side. Long ball floating on that wind. McKimmy judges it the better and controls it in the direction of Sewell. Sewell puts it forward. Can Knowles get a touch? He can't, but Hickling can control the seconds. And away he comes and plays it out in front of Potter. Potter has midfield of Comer, and Comer gets a good touch, and he also drops it back to Hickling, who swaps sides. Hickling in the direction of Snape. Not 100% the right ball, but in the end, Comer puts some pressure on him and comes away with the ball. It's shoulder to shoulder and an interesting play, and now it comes back to Hickling again, who takes the man on down the right hand side and switches the ball into the left. Can Pisani get there? No, the keeper takes it comfortably. Keeper uses all of his 18 yard box and comes off the side of his foot a little bit, and Chapman gets a shoulder, but it only goes as far as Oxley. They put a lovely ball along, and Potter is forced to clear it. Another ball forward, a lovely little run forward, and then, yeah, Knowles comfortably picking that one up. Knowles, Weaver it should be. Good pick up, Lance. It's because my teeth are chattering, to be honest with you. Weaver, a good kick into the wind, but goes straight to Oxley's feet, and he controls it nicely as well down the left-hand side, but Potter drops it back to Nevis. Nevis has Knowles here, which he can use, and that is Knowles, and he doesn't keep it in. Goes out for an Oxley throw. Long throw over the top there. Potter does well. And that finds Knowles' feet too. He bangs it back to Nevis. Nevis controls it to Weaver. Weaver will take a touch, albeit not his best one, and then plays it further out to McKimmy down the left-hand side. McKimmy has Hickling coming towards him and laps him. Plays a ball hitting Snape, but Snape doesn't come far enough forward there. And now there's a big gap forward. They can have a shot, but that's not his best shot. That's gone a long way off target. In fact, we might be flat stick getting that one back. I think it's in the car park. Minutes gone, no score. Just waiting for the keeper to do up his shoelace. In the meantime, Nevis will go over and take the goal kick. He might want to wait for Weaver to put his gloves on there, which he will. A little bit of a delay in play. We're just about ready to go now. So Nevis into the wind. It's not his best ball, that's for sure. It sort of misses everyone and ends up going back to the Oxley player. Puts a lovely ball through, but Nevis fixes up what he did in the direction of Pisani. Good strong efforts there. He plays the ball forward into the Oxley feet. Comes away with it. Nice play down the left-hand side. Potter was strong. Comes away with it. He has the opportunity to play Knowles, and Knowles puts the ball in front of Snape. Can he get a touch? Oh, and the keeper does well right on the edge of the 18-yard box, and Comer goes up and gets the better of the header, and Hickling again takes a touch. He's been everywhere early so far, and he'll tuck it back into... No, he won't tuck it back into Potter. He'll play it forward, and there's Comer there if he wants him. And eventually, there's going to be a foul. Good position for Potter to spring this one. Swing this one in. He leaves it for Hickling though. 7 minutes gone, no score. Nicely on the breeze, there's Sewell. He gets a touch, but not on goal. I'll go out for a goal kick. Yes, it was. early ball out down the left-hand side, playing short. Now getting his head up and looking for a better ball. It only hits it as far as Potter. Potter tucks it into Knowles. Knowles onto Sewell. He hits in the direction of Pisani, but he's wrong-footed and it goes out for a Clairvaux throw. Potter looking for a runner. Snape's there and he'll hit him. Or will he? No, intercepted nicely. Tucked out the back and then the foot's put through it. And Chapman gets a good head on that one. Oxley come away again, trying to go down that left-hand side past Potter, but Potter will allow that to go out of play for a throw. Throw over the top in the direction of Knowles. He tries to keep it in, but he can't. It'll be a Oxley throw. Knowles not happy with it, but I think he got the right decision there. And then the ball into the middle and well defended by Sewell. Sewell looking long towards Snape. Can he get his head on it? He doesn't have to because they all miss it. Knowles pressing and doing a good job having a go at the keeper here. And the keeper outside edge of the foot. Comer plays it forward. Oh, he just had to find Pisani there and it was a big opportunity going forward, but he couldn't find him. Now Oxley come away again. Obviously trying to play the through ball and there's an offside. Nice score, 9.5 minutes gone. Weaver plays it to Nevis. Nevis has Sewell outside him, he plays him. Big gap down the middle with Potter bombing on. He doesn't aim at him, but he plays it out in front of Makumi. Can he get the bounce? And the keeper's come a long way out. He did well though. Needed to, and then it's come back Hickling's way. Hickling needs to bring it under control. He has a pot. That's a good save from the keeper. McKimmy comes away with it after the goal kick. He takes his man on and plays Snape. Snape just gets a foot on and Comer. But Comer hasn't had his best ball there, but he saves it and kicks it out for a throw. Oxley down the right-hand side. Short runner. Snape hasn't got him, so he plays the ball back into the defensive line. And come away, and that's a terrible ball, and it's found Pisani. Pisani has Snape there, or he has Potter outside him. If he can find him, he doesn't. That's just as bad a ball. Two of the worst balls I've seen in about 20 seconds. Gets lucky with it. Knowles, ball towards Snape. Can Snape get up for it? He controls it nicely. He's done really well to control it, but just can't grab the final touch for a shot. And Oxley are forced to kick it long, only as far as Makumi. Makumi plays Sewell, he plays it out to Hickling. Hickling taking a step in towards Snape, who just should have controlled that. That's lazy. That is lazy. Sewell comes away with it again, though. He plays Snape. This time as Snape beats his man. He has a shot, and it's a good save. That's better from Snape. That's what we want to see. Doesn't need those flicks on. Get a foot on it. Oxley down the left-hand side now. And Snape does well to get back, and Knowles is going to press. Some good pressing there. He needs some mates on. He does have them in Comer. But they come away, and Comer copped a little kick there. That's not a great ball. And skips through the middle there, and Chapman has to come out a bit further. Comer hobbling in back play. Snape ducking back into the midfield for him. Well, not quite, though. And there's a dodgy bounce for him, but he controls that nicely. Is he lined up for a shot? He tries to, but it goes to Nevis, to the injured Comer, who can't get his foot around it. And a ball across into the middle. Chapman gets run off the ball. McCormie defends nicely. Bit of everything in the middle, and Chapman does really well in the end, and so does Comer. So does Comer again. Injured and beats two. And they're away to Knowles. Knowles has McCoomey running on. There he is. Can he get a touchback the other way to Knowles? He takes the wrong way. He had two men. He had Knowles and Snape inside. No need to beat a man there. That'll be offside and they'll go out for a throw nonetheless. Chapman with the throw. Looks at Nevis and thinks better of it and throws in the direction of Snape, who flicks it on to no one. Ball comes back into play. Oxley trying to move this ball around. Knowles happy to press and then backs off. No one really making a move for him, so he has to push it down the left-hand side, but Sewell's got him covered on the inside and Comer pinches it. Been some pretty poor passes so far from Oxley, and Fox has yet to capitalise on them completely, but they're certainly getting their foot on the ball regularly. Potter has Nevis back deeper. He takes a touch and then he has Sewell if he wants him, but there's a man on his back. He takes it forward, beats the man we were talking about and plays it into Pisani. Pisani's been called for offside. I don't know about that, but he's called him anyway. A great ball from Sewell and a good touch from Pisani, but the flag's up. No score. 14 and a half minutes gone. Goal kick in the direction of Sewell. Sewell gets a good touch on it, but asked for a foul. They didn't get that. And Comer tries to get away with it and can't. And he'll call a foul that time. They play the ball quickly down the left-hand side. A good sharp move, but it's held up by Comer. He does well to get in the way. Potter gets the foot in and it comes off his shins and it goes out for a Clairvaux throw. Throw gets a lucky bounce and Sewell comes away with it. Can he beat two men? It's probably not the best move. He should have probably held up, but Comer fights really hard and almost comes away with it. And Snape gets a foot in as well. Holds the ball up long enough, so Oxley have to go back into the defensive third. McCoomey pushes high, which is obviously good to see. Forces Oxley to switch sides. They've got a man wide on the left if they want, but a little chip, sneaky little chip over the top does really well. But Potter gets in the way, and then Knowles. And unfortunately, Pisani's ball back is intercepted for a throw-in, and that one will go out for a throw as well. Looking for the long thrower, who'll come up from the wing-back position. Let's see the length of this throw. Really setting up deep in the box, so more on the front edge, but still a good throw nonetheless. And Knowles has read it beautifully. Hickling trying to get a foot in, he can't quite get there, but he causes enough grief to knock the ball back into the defensive line for Oxley. They push it out to the right hand side and again, but it beats his man and goes out for a throw. Throw's taken early and it goes to Chapman, who puts his foot through it in the direction of Snape. Snape can't quite get control of it, but does end up with the ball. Goes back to Comer, who plays the ball across to Nevis. That's a bit risky, but Nevis does really well to control it and comes away with it nicely. He's got Snape through, but he can't quite play him there. That's not the ball to play to Snape, I don't think. But neither's that, and away comes Knowles. Knowles stands his man up and plays it to Sewell. Sewell takes a touch forward, gets tackled, but goes through the tackle, plays it back to Snape, who gets a touch further onto Sewell. Snape's going to have to drop back. No, he won't have to this time. And Hickling's down the right-hand side. Potter's there as well, but he plays a lovely ball forward, and Sewell getting close to pinching that. Keeper did well, though. Comes out with a strong punch. Then Oxley try and counter-attack. Couple of fancy footwork moves. Chapman stands off him. He plays it in the middle, but Hickling's there to clear it. and goes out for an Oxley throw. Throw's taken early. Man holds his player up. Knowles comes firing in, trying to pinch it. Can't. Ball's gone high in the direction of Weaver, who does okay. I won't say great, does okay, and comes away with it. Potter's there. He's got space down this wing. He'll need to play it now, which he does. Pisani will hold that up and drop it back into Hickling. Hickling will play it in front of Knowles. There's a lot of space in this midfield for the Foxes, and he plays it out wider to Makumi. Makumi's got men in the top of the circle. He plays a terrible ball in. You'd have to call it a shot, but it's nothing more than a shot. Looks like Oxley's looking to their bench already, which is interesting at this early hour. Must have an injury. Referee waves it away. Meanwhile, the goal kick's taken. They bang that long. You're not going to beat Nevis to it, though. Nevis is comfortably going to hold that off, and he does, and he gets a push in the back for his trouble. Substitution for Oxley. Obviously, an injury of sort forced to change it up a bit. Nevis will take this free kick, 3 or 4 metres out from the byline, I should say, down the right hand side. Ball put in the direction of Pisani. Pisani can't get there, but Hickling does. Hickling has the opportunity to play Knowles, and he does. He holds it up. He's got Hickling overlapping him, and that's a lovely bit of play. Hickling bounces off his defender. Can he get a ball into the middle? He can. Is it too big? It is, and the defender turns it away nicely. Puts his foot through it, and that'll go out for a Clairvaux throw. The best throw-in I've ever seen, and Oxley will come away with this one. No score, 21 minutes gone. The thrower gets it back, and they push it into the middle, and Hickling tries to pinch it, and he does enough to get Comer the problem, and then Knowles puts it over the top. Can Snape get on that? Not quite. So they're going to come away with it down the right-hand side, Oxley. They play it in the middle, touch it out wider. Oh, dangerous play there. And then Knowles has a big error as well. Sewell has to hold him up. So they tuck it back down the left-hand side with Pisani dropping in to help. He dives in and gets beaten. And they play it back into the middle. Sewell trying to get a foot on it, and he does. And he beats his man. He plays it straight back to where Pisani was. Pisani can play if he wants, but he holds it instead, and then whacks it across field to Makumi, who takes a positive touch forward, as you'd expect. Potter banging down the right-hand side here. If Makumi can find him, he's been given a lot of space today already. Knowles holds the ball strongly. Back to Hickling. Hickling tries to play in the middle, hits the Oxley player, so he plays it back out to Knowles, who flicks it back onto Hickling. That's a lovely ball. Hickling runs into the 18-yard box, beats his man. Can he shoot? He can. It's on target, but simple save for the keeper. Long ball put forward. Chapman gets a good header on it. The seconds are for Oxley, though, and Hickling comes in to clean it up. After just taking that last shot, he's done well to get back into play. Out in front of Sewell, who gets beaten comfortably. And so does Comer. Yeah, referee plays advantage, but Hickling gets in the way of it. Not much movement from Oxley here, so he finds feet. Again. Very stagnant in the forward line. forced to fool around with it a bit, and that's a lovely ball, but McCombie's right there to clean it up, and he tries to play it at snipe, but that doesn't find him, so he runs through and tries to pinch it, and he does very well, and the referee's found a foul there, though. Nice ball into the middle, but it goes straight to Knowles. Knowles gets a foot on it in the direction of Pisani, who controls it beautifully, but he tries to hit it to Knowles, but he can't get it, and Knowles fights him, and he'll get a foul there. It's really well done by Knowles to control that positional play there. Pickling wants him to play quickly, but he won't, so Sewell plays it out to Potter instead. Potter's got a couple in front of him. They ask him to take it, but he puts it towards the keeper instead, and that'll go straight to him. Just sat on the wind and went the wrong way, that one. Wind's still quite strong here behind Oxley. Chapman does very well, finds McCombie. Seems to be able to pass at will here. McCombie tries to play a ball forward. He finds Pisani on the second attempt. He plays the ball across to Comer. He's got Potter outside him even further, but decides to tuck it back the other way, and then he loses possession, but Sewell's there to cover him. Potter, can he find Sewell? He can. That's really well done, and a great bit of work by Sewell. Goes out for an Oxley throw. Now a Clairvaux throw. Potter has an Abbas if he needs him, or he has Snape, or Comer up higher. Comer makes the run late, crosses it in the middle. Oxley get their foot on it. Goes out for a throw-in. Clairvaux throw, half a metre out. Snape gets a little flick on. It's in the direction of Knowles. Can't quite get there. Bit of a scramble in the box. McCombie. Early ball to Hickling. Hickling takes a touch around his player. Forward to Knowles. Knowles has time to spin. Plays in the direction of Pisani. Pisani needs a touch. Can't get one, so Sewell does instead. And they'll come away with the foul. Against Clairvaux. Righto. Long ball in the direction of the winger. He gets a good head on it, but McCombie will go back and clean that up. Yep, he forced to. So he plays the ball in the middle to Nevis. Nevis has time. Again, they leave Potter. Plenty of space out there for Joe Potter today. Potter's got Knowles overlapping and Snape. Can Snape flick it onto Knowles? He can. Can Knowles get there? Not quite. Defender drops back off him. Knowles has Pisani behind him. He's going to rip one in. That's a nice ball. Well kept as well. Needed to be. Snape was pouring down on him. Oh, and Comer fouls him poorly. No score after 26 minutes. As the wind kicks up again, it can't get any colder than this. Comer pressing, can he pinch it? Not quite, but he's making life tough for him to get out. Some good football to end up going through the middle. They look for a long ball, but Potter cleans up there. Ball in the direction of Snape. He drops it back in for Knowles, but not enough on that one. Sewell does really well to get in amongst that and create a drama. McCombie as well, but it goes out for an Oxley throw. Chapman pushes off his man, drops it back in. McCombie creating a drama, and that'll be a foul against him. been a couple of fouls in this sort of region of the pitch. One of the Clairvaux players is down, play on. And the ball dribbles out over the goal line for a goal kick. Not quite a goal kick. Nkoma looks like he's no good at all there. McLean warming up. Can Coma come through this? It looks quite painful. Weaver from the restart plays it out to Nevis. Again, Potter high by himself. And there's a handball. No, play on. Bassani controls it nicely. A couple too many though. They tuck the ball forward. Nevis, a nice kick forward. Bassani tries something fancy to Knowles and manages to get away with it. Knowles has Snape. Can he find him? I think he might be able to. Snape has the chance to take a touch forward and he's been... He probably could have fallen a bit better there. Here comes Makumi. Makumi onto Hickling. Potter out the back again, back to Sewell. Sewell turns his man, holds it into Snape, who drops it off to no one. Eventually plays it into Sewell, who taps it in the middle. They're mucking around with it, the Foxes. They can do better than this here. And that's a foul against the Foxes. And there'll be a substitution here for the Foxes. And a little bit of a restructure, I would have thought, on the back of this one. Comer off, McLean on. So substitution as noted. McLean into the midfield. 15 to go to half time. Long ball forward. Sewell ends up winning it, but it drops back into the Oxley feet and Potter gets a foot on it. They leave it for the defender, plays in the middle, but Hickling hassles him out of it, and then McLean comes away with the ball and he plays a lovely ball to Pisani. Pisani's got McLean going forward. He could have used him then. He should have used him then. He loses it, and the throw gains an extra 5 metres. Goes out for another Oxley throw. Misses his man, and Sewell gets it away, and he plays it towards McLean, but misses it. Good football there, bit of nice passing. They play the ball into the middle, man coming through. Tough ball, but controlled well. Lovely ball in the middle, but Weaver will come out and pick that one up. Weaver well over halfway into the wind in the direction of Pisani. Pisani controls it nicely, has Knowles coming off him. He doesn't use him and does use him. Knowles needs a runner, doesn't have one. Hickling holds it up for him instead. Hickling plays it out to Makumi, but misses the man, and then a foot's put through it all the way down the other end of Weaver. Plays it out to Chapman. Chapman will play it back out to Nevis down the right-hand side, again with Potter high. Not quick enough, defended well. Potter, throwing direction at Knowles. Knowles does well to control it. And gets one. The ref's got the flag on one way and the lino the other. In the end, the referee wins out, obviously. Pisani up for a header, flicks it in the direction of Snape, it's not quite right, but an errant play to McLean, it comes off his foot and plays Hickling on. Hickling has McCoomey running down the outside on him on the left-hand side, he'll turn it back onto his right-hand side and have a ping into the goals, and that's a ripper! You could see that coming from a long way out. You'd almost think that I called it, and the keeper's left absolutely dead. A wonderful goal by McCoomey after his man of the match performance last week against North Brisbane. It's brought the Foxes to life after what must be said a bit of a slow start to the game from both teams. 33 minutes gone, Foxes 1, Oxley 0. Chapman does well. Snape working his way back. Tries to pretend he hasn't got his hand on the back of the man. Gets away with it. And Knowles, brilliant. Can Snape get it back? He does. Good strength. And can't quite get away with it in the end. But Hickling's there to create dramas. He plays it. Oh, that's a lovely touch by the Oxley player to go forward. And beautiful ball over the top. But you're going to be hard-pressed to beat McCoomey there. And Weaver will come over and take a couple of steps and then kicks it into the tree. Minutes gone, Foxes 1, care of Laurent McCoomey, Oxley 0. Oxley dropped the ball back in, a little flick over the top, controls it well, but out for a throw. Snape has McCoomey outside him and Hickling as well. Hickling has McCoomey and away he goes. It'll be a good race between these two. Plenty of pace on both those players and he plays it out in front of Snape. Can Snape get there? He dummies. Doesn't come away with it though. McLean, strong. That's a lovely ball forward. Can McCoomey get there? No. Now they're off to the races. Look at this. Some beautiful football. Man coming through in the second wave. He's held it up nicely. Plays it out in front of him. That's not the best ball forward though, and we will just control that. Looks over the right hand side. Potter again given some space, not as much space as the other times though, and instead he kicks it down the middle to Snape. Snape over the top to the direction of Pisani, but the keeper's forced to come out and pick it up. Rolls it out quickly, but look at Knowles. Look at Knowles. There's the drama. He could make him pay here. Plays the ball into the middle. Where's Snape? Not quite over the top as well as he could have, and that's a good header clearing it away. Snape. Oh, Sewell, brilliant. Gets a great touch. Now Hickling. Knowles again in the direction of Hickling. Hickling takes a touch. Can he finish it? Not quite. Just to the right of the goal. Keeper got a touch. It goes out for a corner. Some beautiful play there though. Potter all by himself and there he is. Can he chip one over the top? He doesn't need to. He plays it back to Hickling. Hickling has him again if he wants him. He does, he plays him, Potter should put it into the middle, outside of the foot, nothing there, McLean, another chance, oh, Oxley scrambling in defence. Lovely switch ball from McCoomey to Hickling, Hickling, too many options almost, ends up slowing it down instead, McLean. A good touch to save it from getting out. He plays a beautiful switch ball to Potter. Potter, who's he got? He's got Pisani. Pisani will take his time and puts a stinker of a ball into the middle. Potter. Over the top of Knowles towards Snape. Flicked on. Oh, how has that not gone in? McCreamy comes away with it as well. It calls for handball, but I don't think that was anywhere near his hand, to be honest. Nevis wanted to control it, didn't quite control it well enough. And what's going on here? Sure, what happened there? A few words and we're away. Early goal kick, but Knowles prevents that. Cooper didn't get all of that one. Oh, but it bounces nastily over the top of Sewell. And Nevis gets him, and that'll be a card for Damon Nevis, I would think. He's grabbed his head, but I don't think he's got anywhere near his head. Now the referee's called him on, now he's pushed him back. Is there a card forthcoming? One would have to think so. Yes, he's got him now. Nevis with the card, after all that. Coach Mapri telling Weaver to watch the shot. There's a pretty good strong wind behind him. I'd like to see Knowles in the second half have a shot with this wind behind him. And he lays it off instead. McCormick presses. They come away down the right hand side again. And then, interestingly enough, they're kicking it in the middle from a more difficult position. And that's going to be a foul as well. Right, now this is a more dangerous position after the foul on Sewell, a foul by Sewell, I should say. Over the ball and to the side. Bit of a wasted shot, that one, you reckon? Nearing half time, 4 minutes to score. Foxes 1, Oxley 0. That hits Pisani. Pisani gets a good header into Hickling. Hickling puts it out in front of McCormy, who's onside. He beats his man, gets half brought down, but rides it beautifully. And then Hickling cuts it into the middle. Well defended, but it goes out for another corner. They're looking sharp moving forward in that final third now. Ever since McLean came on, it seems to be up a notch in terms of speed. Hickling with the corner as per usual. Be a tough one with the wind into his face. Not a bad ball. Pressure's on here. Chapman gets a head up. Sewell gets a foot under it. They're calling for a pen, but nothing happening there. And they come away, Oxley. And Sewell does brilliantly, as you'd expect, to come back and bring it all the way back. And you got to say, that's some excellent football. Come away and get the foul for him and gives Knowles a shot on a goal. Knowles, back stick to Chapman, the keeper does well though. Keeper puts his foot through it, but not one of his better kicks, outside edge of the boot, and it ends up in the direction of Sewell, who gets ahead to it. And Potter, a lovely foot in. Knowles will put some pressure on his man, and does. He keeps fighting. He doesn't stop, does he? And Potter gets beaten down the right-hand side, but McLean works hard to get back. and comes away with it beautifully. Geez, that's a great effort by Alex McLean there too. They play it in the middle. Probably could have taken a touch forward. He had snapped out of position. Back into the middle, but there's McLean again. He gets a foot in and does brilliantly well, as you'd expect. Plays the ball out to Knowles. Knowles the ball forward. Can't quite get there. They bomb it long, and that's going to be offside, I would have thought. Yep, there's the flag. Doesn't matter as it rolls into Weaver's hands. He's played it to Heckling. Heckling. Nice ball to McLean. McLean on to Potter. Potter tries to launch in the direction of Snape, who does a pirouette like the Queen Mary, that one. And Sewell steals it beautifully. Gets fouled, but twice. And the referee decides it's not enough. Ball goes forward, so Nevis gets his foot on it. There's McLean again. McLean has... Oh, it hits the referee, and that'll be a Clairvaux ball. What do you got? A minute left on the clock, I would have thought. Potter's had so much space down this right-hand side. Knowles, not his best touch. And that ball has been kicked a billion miles away for a goal kick. Nearing half time. What have we got? 45 seconds. I think Lance is asking for another goal. I'd be quite happy going in at 1-0 into this wind. Plays it out to Chapman. Chapman has McCormie outside him. Can he use him? He doesn't. He takes it down the middle instead and plays a centralised ball in the direction of Snape, but he can't find it. But Sewell can. He puts it out further. Oh, Knowles ended up underneath the player completely by accident, but it's created an opportunity for Oxley down the left-hand side. It's been a good tussle between Nevis and this bloke, and that goes out for an Oxley throw. Deep in the attacking third. Long throw into the middle, but it's straight at Nevis. Nevis puts it back and says, have another go. We're in the extras of the first half now. It's a nice ball in the middle. Chapman had to clear it. Comes back Knowles' way. And he gets a touch there. Beautifully done. Look at the pressure he's putting on him here, and he touches it away nicely from him. Through the middle now. Big touch. Looking for runners, but none forthcoming, so they push it out to the right-hand side. There's a nice ball into the middle, but Potter will jump up and clear that one. Can Pisani help? He'll need to. He'll turn and have a shot here, I reckon. Here's the shot. Oh, lovely ball to the left. And another lovely ball. They're a little short here, the Foxes, and there's a great ball forward, but just out of reach on that wind. You won't see a Weaver doing anything but taking his time here. The ball rolls down the hill. Now, Weaver with the goal kick. A minute and a half of extra time played. And that's not a great ball, but Snape will end up with it, and he controls it to Sewell, who plays a wonderful ball in direction of McCormie. I'm not sure how he's done that. Can McCormie find McLean? Not far away. Comes off the Oxley player to Heckling. Heckling has men in the second phase play he could use. Holds it up. Holds it up again. Continues to hold his man, and that'll... Well, it's a good tackle, but he doesn't come away with it. Now it's onto the back stick. Can Pisani get onto it again? And it's in the back of the net! 2-0, Pisani too easy. Right on the stroke of half time. Put that goal down to Ryan Hickling's tenacity. But a lovely finish with the head by Daniel Pisani. Takes the Foxes to a 2-0 lead with nothing left on the clock at half time. Can't be long in the clock, although we did have a couple of intermissions, I suppose, and that's a good touch down the left-hand side. Good touch by McLean. Not really anyone there, and Snape drops back in nicely. That'll be a foul. He'll come away with that one, that's for sure. You saw that, did he? You just made that up. Well, we had three and a half minutes of extra time in the first half. This is an ominous position. Oh, we could have done a bit stronger than that, although McLean gets a head on it, goes out for a corner. Mapri complained about half time, saying it's 5 minutes. He's completely wrong. I like pointing that out. What can Oxley do here right on the stroke of half time? It's a good ball. He'll get another go at it too. Oh, Willie McCoomey came racing at Pisani, gets a good head on that. That's handy. Up to the left hand side, and Pisani does well again. He controls it, and then we'll call that half time. I dare say the Foxes will be quite happy with that result so far. 2-0 at the break. Goals to McCoomey in the 34th, and Pisani right on the stroke of half time. Allows us in the commentary area to take a well-earned break with the stats there. You can see shots on target well and truly dominated by the Foxes. It'll be an interesting second half. Look forward to seeing you in about 15 minutes.
Where it began, I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Touching hands, reaching out, touching me. Thank you.
where it began. I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me.
I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me.
I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring.
Rightio. Second half underway. Chapman coming away with the ball down the left-hand side. Plays it at Pisani. He's got McCombie, but ignores him and drops back in. Not his best ball there. McCombie forced to clean up after him. A lovely ball forward, but it's only as far as Chapman, who plays a good ball into the middle, but a lovely touch. McCombie fighting hard. He's been good again tonight. McLean, a good touch forward. He plays it on Pisani. He plays one of those flicks that we all hate, and it's request for Nevis to fix it up and Potter to put his foot through it. Sewell, in the end, has to head it away. And that'll be a foul against the Foxes. Large number of fouls against them, as you can see. 9-3 on your screen there. And that's a lovely ball in the middle, but Weaver comes out and picks it up comfortably. Oh, terrible ball forward, but luckily Knowles gets a bit of a foot on it. It ends up going out Hickling's way, and he drops it back into Chapman. Sewell comes away with it. Eventually, Knowles turns into trouble and they put his foot through it, but that's not going to do too much. And in the end, come foul against the Foxes. Thank you. We're all over Knowles. He's obviously caught one. Doesn't look too comfortable. That'd be a big loss if the Foxes had to play the rest of the game without him. Robbie Knowles on his haunches. Not calling. That's Coma with an ice pack strapped to his calf. Knowles is on his feet, but he's very ginger. He's trying to walk it out, but he's making his way towards the sideline. Referee happy for it to proceed now after a bit of a delay in game. Nice little chip over the top and it tries for the miracle plays in the middle. Nevis, Sewell. Sewell comes away with it strongly. It had to be. Snape gets a poor foot on it. Hickling has to clean it up and then half a shot with a wicked bounce. But Weaver does well to come away with it. He just slow it down for a second. Doesn't quite get the head on it, so Pisani works hard to try and pinch it. Makumi with a little bit of pace tries to drop in, but Oxley come away with the ball. And then a good move down the right-hand side, still showing the class that the man has. Lovely player for Oxley historically, and then a high foot, and that'll go against Oxley. As Knowles is going to make his way back on. He still looks pretty ginger. As Nevis is over the ball. One of the Oxley players dropping a little deep. Snape's probably got a bit more space than he thinks, and Pisani lets it go. Makumi's in the middle by himself, and he puts it at the top of the net. And that's the third. I think Makumi caught Oxley completely asleep there. He certainly wasn't offside. In the end, that takes them out to a 3-goal lead early in the second half. Gone in this game. 3-0 to the Foxes. That goal is going to cause a few dramas, I think, for Oxley to come back here. But they're a tenacious side. Unless Knowles can steal that, which he does. Pisani with the back heel. Snape shoots over the top. Could have put it to bed there. Push forward, McLean again making a nuisance of himself. He's played beautifully again this evening. A few more minutes than he's used to, and that's a foul against him, just as I give him a rap. Ball off the outside edge of the boot, but goes in the right direction. McCormie forced to stand up and then take another touch and catch up with the other bloke. Again, he's there, probably fouled the man, gets away with it, and Chapman gets a foot to it in the direction of Pisani, who drops it back to Knowles, who then puts it forward again to Pisani. That's a lovely ball. Can he get a handle on it? He can. No, he can't. Goes out for a Oxley throw. That'll be a Fox's throw. No, he's called it the other way. No, he hasn't. He had his hand up the other way and let it play on. Not sure what's going on here, and I'm damn sure they don't. It's a nice ball forward and well-controlled. Potter defending vigilant, defending as best he can. Hickling gives the foul away. Mapri making a sub. Pisani is at a great game, and he's going to be substituted for Peacock. Peacock coming off a double in the reserve grade game. Be interesting to see what he can do here. It's a nice ball forward. Can Weaver has to catch that. It's a lovely ball. He rolls it out quickly in front of Makumi. He's got the wheels, but so's the defender there. And then another touch sideways. He's got McLean in front of him. He uses him, who has players running everywhere, and he kicks it to the only Oxley player that was really going to make a difference. But he runs through and gets the ball back. What's he going to do here? He takes it wide. He's going to give up a foul. He's going to give up a foul. Oxley trying to fight their way down the left-hand side. Peacock ducks back in and holds the man up. And McLean comes away with the ball. And that'll be another foul against the Foxes. The fouls are definitely getting up there, 14-4. Referee might need another whistle after this one. And ball goes wide down the right-hand side. They've got a few numbers down here. Plays a nice ball forward, but Chapman's there, and that helped. Oh, that's a lovely touch. He's done beautifully there. But the ball's a little bit too far forward. And oh, Weaver does brilliantly. Brilliant drag back there. Another strong game. He'll be happy with that donut beside his name at the moment. And keen to keep it that way. Puts the ball forward. Can't quite find Snape. Knowles will tuck that back out to Potter. Potter will rip this one in as he always does. It's towards Snape. Can Snape get up? No, the keeper gets a bounce. And takes it comfortably. Chapman trying to judge that wind. Does well in the end, but that's well controlled as well. Sewell fouls his man. No, calls it play on. Much to the protests of the Oxley player. Then Hickling hits it out wider to Makumi. Makumi, oh, that's not his best pass either. That gives Oxley an opportunity to come away, and Sewell, not on a yellow card, he'll keep going hard. Dropped into the middle. Good steal by Knowles. He leaves it to Sewell. Sewell gets tackled. Oxley drop it back, trying to find something. That's not going to be it. Or is it? It might be. No, Sewell, too good. Knowles came in a bit dangerously there, I think.
Yeah, but they had possession.
It's all right. I don't think Knowles is too happy with that one. Lovely ball into the middle. Got the opportunity to put that away, but that's far from the best shot I've ever seen, and it's not even going to go out over the byline. And McLean willing it over the line, but he's not going to get it to, so he punches it in front. And look at that, Hickling's there and Snape's there, and Hickling's got Peacock plus Knowles across the other side. Plays the ball out in front of Peacock, a lovely run. The defender misses him, recovers, plays the ball in the middle. It's dropped in. Can he get a touch? He can't. Oh, Lance going off a bit early there, jinxing us all. It's a nice ball over the top, but Nevis strong as always. Thrown over the top, a lovely bit of control there. They get another throw. McLean comes away with the ball. Plays, Peacock does well, plays it to Potter, Potter back into Peacock. Fouls being called for everywhere, none forthcoming here. A bit messy, but he's well, the Oxley player comes away with the ball, sort of, but in the end, he's going to get a throw. Hickling controls it beautifully in the direction of Knowles. Snape has to get out of his way, which he sort of does. McCoomey. Nice little slide tackle there, comes away with it. Sewell holds his line, and there's a good ball. After all that, the free kick amounts to nothing. Or does it? They bang it back into the middle and Knowles does well to intercept it. And that's a good bit of attacking play, and then I'll go out for a goal kick. What have we got? 63 minutes gone. Foxes 3, Oxley 0. Anyway, away we go again. Trying to get some rhythm in this game, hopefully. Lovely ball into the middle. Distributes it, but Potter saves that one. And then it out to Sewell, who gets an errant touch, but then fixes it. And then out to Knowles. Knowles cops a little touch. And Chapman comes through, and he's played strongly there. And well tackled. Makumi, another good tackle. Lucky he got rid of that one. I think he would have got fouled. Snape holds it up for way too long with Hickling running down the right-hand edge. And that's going to be some repercussions over here, I would have thought, with the guy fouling McCormie afters, and there's a yellow card for him. All rolled back to the keeper, and away we go again. Let's see if we can get a flow this time. 65 minutes gone. It seems like it's been going for an hour and a half this game, but anyway. Makumi recovered. Kicks the ball into the Oxley defence. It doesn't go out because that wind kicks up just at the wrong time, and Chapman has to put his foot through it directly to the Oxley player, but he makes a meal of it. Now a lovely little ball by Hickling onto Knowles, but doesn't find his man. Runner down the right-hand side, if he can find him, he ignores him, and it goes to Nevis. Nevis pushes it out further, and now Oxley are back on. Can they get a shot in? No, and McLean does brilliantly, gets fouled for his trouble, and he'll get the free kick. Weaver will wander over and take this one. Nice ball forward, well defended. Sewell trying to get himself a yellow card somehow, I think. It's a nice ball over the top, but McCormie's going to come away with it. And then out to Knowles. Knowles will put the ball around Snape. That's not how to play Snape. I'll go all the way forward to the keeper. Cooper launches it as best you can into that wind. Chapman gets a strong head onto it, and then Peacock, another one over the top. Comes out to the right hand side to McLean. McLean plays Hickling. Hickling's forced to use the back heel. He's got Potter, but ignores him. He plays it forward to McLean, who turns and plays it back to Potter. A little bit too much on that, so he has to stop and prop, and that's going to cause him to lose it, or is it? Yes, it is. And Oxley come away with it. They've got numbers in the middle if they can find them. They seem too intent on tricking everyone. In the end, it goes out for a Clairvaux throw. Long throw forward by Potter, and Snape knocks that on. Can McLean get a touch in? He can't, and it goes out for their throw, though.68 minutes gone in this one. Foxes 3, Oxley 0 after the earlier game went the same score and the same way. Potter Long throw towards Snape, misses everyone. Lands dangerously, but they clear it away. Sewell leaves it for Chapman. Chapman gets a good header in the right direction. Finds Knowles, but he can't find anyone in turn. Now McLean. McLean takes a great turn. Stands on it, though, at the last minute. And loses it. There's a player running down the right-hand wing. Can they find him? It's a lovely ball. But Weaver comes out and smashes that as high as you can possibly hit a ball. No one's going to head that, I told you. And in the end, Peacock holds it up and plays it, lays it back out to Hickling. Hickling's got McCoomey outside him, but loses the ball completely. You can't make some of this up, I tell you. Chapman being a bit delicate after getting an early yellow. That's a bit more entertaining by Oxley. Can he put his foot through it? He does, but it just hits Sewell. And that one, oh, that's in a dangerous one, out of position, and Nevis is left to save that. He can't. Oh, you'd almost call that a pass back, wouldn't you? Anyway, Weaver was happy with it, and he makes Peacock run. You could hear the groans as soon as he kicked it. Peacock does well to hold it up and then plays it back to Knowles. Knowles has Snape or a switch play to McLean. Can it get over the defender? It can. McLean comes in. Well defended. They push it down the left-hand side again. And back through the middle. The midfield's sort of lacking there for the Foxes, but Knowles turns around and half rolls his ankle. He's in the wars tonight. Chapman does really well to put the Oxley player under a bit of pressure, and he's forced to use the keeper. Keeper goes short. There's just no movement in the forward line for Oxley. Relying on some good foot skills when they actually do get the ball. Snape drops it back out to Potter. That's good footy. And Potter will come down the right-hand edge. He's got Snape going forward. And there he is. Can he get the touch on it? Not quite. McCoomey just out of play there. Gets a touch. Snape's got two. He holds it himself, lays it off to Peacock. And Peacock kicks it into the defender's bum. McLean, Knowles, couldn't quite get it. They come away again, Oxley. He attacks him at pace, and there comes a foul. Well, you can hear it. I don't need to. I'm sorry, but that's a foul every day of the week. That's a foul, mate. He's the two of them. Away we go again, and McCoomey tries to find Snape. He gets a little flick over the top and recovers it himself. He has the opportunity to put his foot through it, and he does, but that's not going to trouble the keeper. Peacock putting some great pressure on him. and Hickling. Oh, that's an interesting ball. I like that one out to the left hand side. Nevis does well. Potter struggling to get a control there. Sewell can't get there either. They're controlling the ball beautifully here, Oxley. It's good feet. Isn't really going forward though, and in the end they get a throw in. He controls that nicely. Goes past Hickling, so McLean will try and get a foot in. Plays the ball into the middle, and Potter does get a foot in. And that ball goes directly to Sewell. Another errant pass, and there's been a fair few, and then there'll be the softest of soft fouls against Oxley. Weaver wants it. I think it's a bit far out for him. Not after they pass it back to him, though. Nevis quickly plays Chapman. Chapman's got Makumi outside him. He doesn't use him. He uses Knowles instead. Knowles has heaps of space and plays a lovely ball out in front of McLean, who's... That is embarrassing. Anyway, an offside call when the guy was 10 metres onside. All good though. No problem. We're away again. That's some lovely play again. Oxley looking a lot better, sharper now, but they just can't tend to get forward. And just as I say that, perhaps that's the one. No, that's not going to trouble Weaver. There's still 15 minutes of this to go. Score, Foxes 3, Oxley 0. Good ball in direction of Peacock, doesn't get his head on it. But Knowles runs through beautifully and steals it. He's got Makumi outside him, he's got Snape there, and he's on. And he's on, and Snape can bury the game. But he doesn't put it in the back of the net. Oh, that's not his best touch. Chance of Peacock. Interesting try. Not really anywhere near it. But it was the right idea. Oh, and Sewell fouls his man. Yep, there it is. It. Let's see what Oxley can do here. See if they can. That's a lovely ball as well. He's good from the dead ball, and that's propped. Weaver high and takes it. Well bowled out in front of Hickling. Hickling has got Peacock in front of him, has got Snape in front of him, and has Makumi. But Snape has got it. All he's got to do is get a touch and put it in. And he can't. Good touch there. Hickling does even better, and that'll he'll get the foul against Oxley there. What can Knowles do here? Way too far out, but you never know with him. It's not his best one, that's for sure. Goes straight to the Oxley player and forces Potter to drop back and slow things up. It's a nice ball forward, but no one's there waiting for it, so it's going to roll all the way to the keeper, and Weaver's just going to take his time and force Oxley to come and get him. Long bomb in the direction of Snape. Covered by Oxley, but went to Hickling, and Snape takes another touch that's a bit large. It's a good bit of footy, but then he loses it, so Snape's got options to his left. Can he duck it back in? No, he has a shot. And a substitution for Oxley. No. McGumey does a lap. Trying to find some help. He finds Hickling. No, he doesn't. Chapman blocks that one out for an Oxley throw. Early throw. It was all Oxley there, but Chapman got a very useful header in there to Peacock. He plays it back to Chapman. Chapman in front of Snape. Can Snape put his foot through it? He holds it up, back heel to no one. Lovely touch around Peacock, and an even better ball, but McLean comes through with force. Hickling, can he get on for a shot? No, he drags himself back out. There's no second phase there for him, and he plays it into McLean. McLean will kick it, and I think there might be a card there. No.
Happy with that.
And they quickly take it down the right-hand side. They try and find man going forward, and they do. Good hole in the midfield there, not covered. You push it out to the left-hand side. McLean left to do the work back there. Lovely ball in the middle, and a good save by Weaver. That's probably Oxley's best opportunity of the match. And Weaver palms it over the top for a corner.
Who'd be happy with that donut? Weaver or Snape?
High ball. Weaver gets a punch, but it comes back out for him. And then luckily bounces straight into his arms, and he's away to Potter. Potter, no one in front of him. They're chasing him down. He's got Peacock up higher. He's got Snape making some room. Potter, a ball in the direction of Snape. Snape ends up with it. He takes it onto his left foot with Knowles coming behind him. In the end, it's a Fox's throw. McCombie's got it. He throws it back to Hickling. That's a good throw. Takes a nice touch, doesn't beat his man though, that's well done. Chapman gets half a touch, but they're still on here. Sewell slows him up just enough. That's a lovely ball. And Weaver, brilliant. Again Weaver, brilliant again. It's really done by Robbie Weaver. Be very happy with that, fighting so hard for that donut. Two good saves late in this game to keep Oxley on nil. Oh, and Potter messed that up, and he'll get a yellow card. More of a mistake than anything, but still, the error was there.
What was wrong with Weaver last week when he went down it?
Nice spot here for the free kick. Good opportunity to curl one in. 6 minutes left in the half. Another corner. Jumbler bodies ending up in a corner. It's a good looking corner. And Chapman gives it everything. Snape can't quite get there, but he's there by himself, so he's going to have to work extra hard. Oxley bring it back quickly. Good tackle, well broken though. McCormey fouls him. Another opportunity for Oxley going forward. There's not his best one of his free kicks. Potter gets ahead on it and clears it away. They go around him then. A lovely 1-2. And there's another player in the midfield. And Foxes are a bit deep here. And he's been called offside. Nervous over this one. Plenty of wind to get it onto, I know that much. It's getting colder and colder by the minute. In the direction of Peacock. Can't win the header, but it comes down Fox's way, but Fox's throw in and around halfway. Snape plays it off to Hickling. A lovely bit of play, leaves it for him. He shoots it in the direction of the keeper. He uses his foot, oddly enough. Long kick off the outside edge of his boot. Almost kept it. And he's not happy with that, so that's going to be a foul. Can you tell me what that foul was for, Lance?
No, I don't know. I don't know. He said you're blocking him from the ball was 20 metres away.
I'm not convinced it was 20 metres, but all good. Still gets his head on that one. They push it out to the left-hand side. Hickling holding his man up, gets beaten. Does a good job there. McLean cleans it up and that'll go out for an Oxley corner. Oh, that's a good ball, but it's McLean clearing that one, or was it Chapman? Whoever it was, they did a good job. Now he's back onto his right foot. He takes a shot. Donny goes as far as the defender. Knowles waits for the referee to get out of the way and then plays McCormey. McCormey has Chapman, who touches the ball forward to Snape, and Snape's going the wrong way, but it wasn't the best ball by Chapman, to be fair. And Sewell does really well and then gives away a foul. Ball into the middle. Very good touch, but McLean saves that one and hits it out to Hickling. Hickling's sort of got no one really going forward, so trying to find Snape. But the defender's in the way there. Knowles comes through. Can he create a drama? Not quite. Oxley get the ball. Again, they've pushed a lot of guys forward, Oxley. To their credit, they're playing four up front at least. Takes the ball into the corner. They drop it all the way back into their back line. Sewell, brilliant. Needs a runner. McCombie's left. He should always be looking left with McCombie, but that's sat on the wind and gone out for a Oxley throw. Play the ball out to the right-hand side. They've got some good feet there. Oh, lovely step through three of the Foxes. Will he have a ping? No, he'll pump it out wide. That's a lovely ball, and Weaver takes that well. It's almost coming up to 90 minutes. Coach Mapri asks how much injury time. The answer should be heaps. Game seems to not even got to a start, let alone a progression, and Hickling does very well to steal that. He's got plenty of opportunities and he gets fouled, but Peacock plays it out to McCombie. McCombie, the opportunity for a hat-trick. Can he get a shot on goal? He takes it and hits it miles over the bar. And certainly wasted their chances, the Foxes. I wouldn't have thought that's a hard question. Oxley come forward again. Nice little pass there through the middle. Can they thread the needle? There he is on the right-hand side. Sewell drops in to defend. Another good ball. Sewell wrong-footed, but the referee tells the attacker to get up. Then Potter puts his foot through it. There's no one there except Snape, but he can't control it. Lovely ball at the left-hand side now, and that's knocked through. Potter's going to have to knock that out. He gets clipped after the fact and picks up the foul. Hope substitutes on for Hickling. Not sure what that foul was for, but it's the Foxes' 20th foul against them, which is an unbelievable amount. But anyway, 2 minutes into extra time, and I dare say there'll be a fair bit of pumps it back out the left-hand side. Looking for someone up top, but they're just standing flat. There we go, he's found one. And McLean defends brilliantly, to be honest. Good ball in the middle, but Nevis is there. Coming back here at pace, Oxley. They love that left-hand side. They're going down there again. Tucked into the middle, but no one's there, so Hope is the only one, and he plays Snape on. It's Snape. Can he do some damage here and finish one for himself? He beats him one way, he can't beat him the other. Knowles. Lovely ball in the middle, Sewell, who has to stop and prop. He's got the opportunity to shoot. Can he take it? He's off balance, and that's not a good shot. And he cups it from his mates for it. Early goal kick out. That's a lovely ball down the right-hand side. Chapman forced to defend. Good turn. Has he got feet, enough feet? No, he misses his man, and then Hope is there, and that'll be the end of the game. Well, it wasn't the best looking game you'll ever see, that's for sure. But 3-0 with two goals to Makumi and one to Pisani. I'm sure the Foxes will take that, and that'll be that'll be 3 points that they wanted. We'll be back in a couple of minutes with the man of the match. I'm here with the Dosa Hut and City Cave man of the match for this evening's win against Oxley 3-0, and it's Alex McLean. Well done, Al.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks,
mate. Nice and cold this evening. Lance and I just about froze to death, but it sort of transposed into the game. Yeah, not the strongest games from the boys, was it?
No, not really, but they're the ones you have to win, I guess, if you want to make a real run at it, and we haven't had any that we've really played well and got out of a result this year, so it's good to get one under our belt.
Yep. Russell was complaining about the numbers at training. You rocking up the training?
Oh, mate, I had a pretty decent excuse on Thursday, I must say, but yeah, Paul's there on Tuesday. I'll be there both times this week, so supposed to go to New Zealand next week, but I'll be here for the rest of the season.
Nice one. And what about the trip to Willowburn? You avoiding that on purpose? Is that what you're doing?
I was trying to, but COVID has kept me in the state, so I'll be there.
All right, mate. Well, as always, it's a pleasure to have you for a chat, and I must congratulate on a good game. The Dose Hutton City Cave man of the match for this evening, Alex McLean. Well done, Al.
Cheers, mate. Cheers, Lance.